Welcome to the Investors Trading Academy Talking Glossary of Financial Terms and Events. Our word of the day is moving average. A moving average is one of the most flexible as well as the most commonly used technical analysis indicators. It's highly popular among traders, mostly because of its simplicity. It works best in a trending environment. In statistics, a moving average is simply a mean of a certain set of data. In case of technical analysis, these data are in most cases represented by closing prices of stocks for the particular days. However, some traders also use separate averages for daily minima and maxima, or even an average midpoint values, which they compute by summing up daily minimum and maximum and dividing it by two. Yet, you can construct a moving average also in the shorter time frame, for example by using daily or minute data. For example, if you want to make a 10-day moving average, you just add up all the closing prices during the last 10 days and then divide it by 10. In this case, it's a simple moving average. The next day we do the same, except that we again take the prices for the last 10 days, which means that the price that was in last in our computation for the previous day is no longer included in today's average. It's replaced by yesterday's price. The data shift in this manner with every new trading day, hence the term moving average. Moving average is a trend following indicator. Its purpose is to detect the start of a trend, follow its progress, as well as to report its reversal if it occurs. As opposed to charting, moving averages do not anticipate the start and the end of a trend. They only confirm it, but only sometime after the actual reversal occurs. It stems from their very construction, as these indicators are based solely on historical data. The fewer days a moving average contains, the sooner it can detect a trend's reversal. It's because of the amount of historical data, which strongly influences the average. A 20-day moving average generates a signal of a trend reversal sooner than the 50-day average. However, it's also true that the fewer days we use in the moving average's computation, the more false signals we get. Hence, most of the traders use a combination of several moving averages, which all have to yield a signal simultaneously before a trader opens his position in the market. Nonetheless, a moving average's lag behind the trend cannot be completely eliminated.